better acknowledge responsible for the fixtures or to Dolph Thorns, and I was responsible for the program.
I'm Dustin Siegel, and
I'm Drew Derry.
We were at the wiring camp control panel.
This is Team Ballers, and this is the paintball workshop. So to start this thing off, we're going to go ahead and give it a double off start. We're going to go to a home position, and then it's going to work down to the box.
Wait for a choice to be made.
So while the robot's waiting, on our control panel we have double op start to start the robot. We have a level 2 e-stop which kills the robot and the controller to the robot. We have our pneumatics, we have our regulator followed with our pressure sensor or gauge. Then we issued in two choices, so when it's waiting right now you push either 10 paintballs or 50 paintballs. And we have our MCR on and off, which controls our pneumatics and our motor that we put into this feeder. Which, to let you know that it's on, we have the amber light for main power. And we have the robot moving light and robot stop light. When the robot moving light is off, the red light will come on. And if the red light is off, the green light will come on. We've put them on at the same output, so they can't be on at the same time. So we're going to go ahead and go 10 paintballs for the first time. So our robot's going to grab the first pod, and it's going to bring it right over to our feeder.
Alright, the feeder's going to load in paintballs into the pod now. There's 10 paintballs. Now it's going to bring it over to our blade closing station. The robot's going to place it in the pod holder.
Alright, so this is a demonstration of our e-stop. So it stopped and it alerts you on the screen, emergency press 5 to continue.
Right here we have two relays that control two different solenoids for our paintball feeder. They are controlled individually so that we can time the dropping of the paintballs. And then if you move over right next to this, we have our two relays that are wired in parallel for our sensors that sense if there are any pods left in the pod holder. They are wired in parallel, so they both need to be off for it to actually change the input selection. And then if you move over here even farther to the left, we have our closing station set up. We have a relay, a time relay wired off of a normal relay because we can only use one output, and those control two separate solenoids, for one for the linear slide and one for the stamp that closes the lid.
Now that the light curtains have been tripped, you can see now that the red light has come on and the green light has come off. And the way that we have it wired up to reset the whole process is by pushing the double op start. Shoot. And the green light comes back on to let you know that it's moving. And then it's waiting again for either 50 or 10. We'll do 50 this time.
First, the robot comes over and picks up a pod from our pod holder that can hold 6 pods. It then takes it to the paintball feeder, in which there are 2 cylinders spaced perfectly apart so that there's 10 paintballs inside of them. The 5-gallon bucket is there to hold all the paintballs because we needed a lot of paintballs, so we decided a 5-gallon bucket would have been perfect. We had to troubleshoot a motor onto the paintball bucket so that the paintballs could get stirred up and they could get into the tube. The robot waits for the paintballs to get in the tube right here.
I'm just gonna skip over this whole part. Last skip it.
It looks like it's dropping like 5 at a time. Doesn't it? It probably is.
No, it's good for more, but.
That one looks like 5. Hello. Pod then comes over to our lid closure, which is placed in a single pod holder that is attached to a linear slide that allows it to go backwards and forwards. It now moves back and the lid closes the pod. The robot picks up the pod from the single pod holder and drops it in. It then grabs the pod and drops it in our gravity chute that sends the product to the operator.
Never been.